Hey, what's up? It's me, Warren, here again with another video. So in this video, I'm gonna be answering an email which I received. I received a couple emails stating that their eggs got their rebound pregnant. How to handle that? What should they do? You know, how they deal with, you know, the emotional detachment from that person so they won't suffer anymore. What's the steps they can take? First, I want to say that, you know, I understand that it can be devastating. It can be hard, you know, because you're still attached to this person emotionally. And it can be, you know, very hard to deal with. But the first thing you need to understand is you got to let that person go. And nothing you can do. Nothing you can do. And you can't control that person. And the only person you can control is yourself and what you do. So let's start there. You know, the first thing you want to do is, you know, take baby steps and detach yourself from this person. You know, ask yourself, what's the benefit of having this person in your life? You know, do this person serve a purpose in my life? The best thing you want to do is really let this person go. Stop worrying about what they're doing. Stop worrying about who they're doing it with. Because trust me, in time, you will see what will happen to this person. Not to wish anything bad on anyone, but it's this thing that called karma. Karma is real. If you do someone wrong, you put that energy out into the world, and that will come back to you. So the thing is, with that being said, it's this guy in the Bible. I'm going to use this Bible story to show you what to do and how to handle your situation. His name was Job. He lost his family, his wealth, even his health. He lost everything. And he had nobody to depend on but God. But not knowing, he was getting tested. See, the problems come in your life for a reason, to test you. And they test you to make you a better person. Because you're going to go through other problems. And this test, first test, is building you up to go through that second problem. That's probably worse than this. But it won't seem as bad because you got tested before. It all builds character. You know. But anyway, Job was getting tested for his, you know, you see, where his faith, his mental strength, and all that. And through all the tough times, he kept his faith in God. And God seen that. You know, he seen it and he blessed him with double. See, the thing is, the more of this story, what I want to tell you is this. If you was in that relationship and you did everything you possibly can do and you was 100 with that person, you was kind, honest, you didn't cheat, venture out, you did everything which what you supposed to do in that relationship. Just like Job, you're going to be blessed because you was tested. You kept your faith. You kept your commitment. Now that person who venture out of that relationship, you can't control that person, you know? And the thing is, you got to understand too, everything you see, touch, and come across is temporary. You know, everything have an expiration date. So a lot of times people try to hold on to things that we're not supposed to hold on to. Understand this, a lot of times we hold on to things that's not really good for us to hold on to. Maybe that person was bad, not a good thing to hold on to. But understand this, in time, you will see, if you keep living, you will see a difference. That person will, you know, suffer. Because that person, that rebound, thinking they getting a good thing. They thinking they winning. But when that pain starts setting in, that person causing them, you know, that aggravation, argument, and all that stuff start to sit in, you know, they gonna see what they really got. And by that time, you should be doing good. You know, you should be doing fine. If you keep on working on yourself and improving yourself, you know, work on your mindset, work on your finances, you know, and also improve your body. Once you do those steps, you become a better person. So you'll be ready to face anything. That's why I always say work on yourself. So no problems come, you'll be ready. Now keep in mind, you came a long way already. You know, God ain't brought you this far to leave you where you at. The lessons that you learned and going through, learn from them. So therefore, you can know what you want. And understand this too, that person leaving out your life is not a bad thing. It's a good thing. Now there's room for the right person to come in your life and treat you like how you're supposed to be treated and how you want to be treated. And that'll cherish you. You know, just like Job, he got everything he wanted. God bless him because he kept the faith. Do not turn bitter. Don't turn hateful. You know, all people ain't bad. You know, there's somebody out there for everybody. So just keep the faith and you'll be okay. You know, but with that being said, you know, just stay improving. Choose your goals over a relationship. Relationships come and go. Learn detachment. Everything got an expiration date. You know, happiness is what you make it. Do not chase after this person. If they leave your life, celebrate. You know, now there's room for someone better. If that person leaves, there's room for someone that's even better. You know, value yourself because you're the prize at the end of the day. People treat you how you want to be treated. You know, now with that being said, peace, take care.